Today's class, we'll be doing some more problems on Nyquist stability criterion. I hope you have gone through the problems that were solved in the earlier classes. The problem statement I'll read out: a negative feedback system has an open loop transfer function g of s h of s is equal to phi divided by s into s plus 1. Investigate the closed loop stability of the system for the following cases by excluding the pole of g of s h of s, pole of g of s h of s at s equal to 0. Similarly, by including the pole of again g of s h of s at s equal to 0. Here pole means the pole of the transfer function g of s h of s. We shall do the solution now. I'll take the first case. To find P, the open loop transfer function is g of s h of s is equal to phi divided by s into s plus 1. S plane is a complex plane having real axis sigma, imaginary axis j omega. This is the S plane. Having real axis sigma, imaginary axis j omega. Poles are nothing but the roots of the denominator polynomial of the open loop transfer function g of s h of s. We have a pole at s equal to 0. We have a pole at s is equal to minus 1. The pole at s equal to 0 must be taken to the LHS of the S plane. The pole at s is equal to 0 should be taken to LHS of the S plane. If you take the LHS of the S plane, it means excluding the pole at s equal to 0. So I am going to say now, this pole is definitely on the left hand side. The controversy is about this pole, which is at the origin, because the pole at the origin belongs to both left hand side of the S plane and right hand side of the S plane. We have to exclude the pole at the origin base. The pole at the origin must be taken to left hand side of the S plane. So this is the figure that represents right hand side of the S plane. Now S plane is a complex plane and real axis sigma, imaginary axis j omega. Let this contour be traversed in the clockwise direction. This is a semicircle of radius. This is a semicircle of radius r tending to 0, very small circle. This is the angle phi. The radius of the circle is r tending to 0. This radius vector makes an angle phi with respect to sigma axis. This is plus j 0. This is minus j 0. This is plus j infinity, minus j infinity. This is a semicircle of radius r tending to infinity. This angle is theta. Now let me, what is the equation of this semicircle? Equation of this semicircle is s is equal to limit r tending to 0 r into e to the power j phi. Equation of this semicircle is s is equal to limit r tending to infinity r into e to the power j theta. Now let me label the contour. This I call A, this I call B, this is C, this is D, this is E, this is F. The contour ABCD EFA is traversed in the clockwise direction. So now technically what I mean is, this is the right hand side of the S plane. This real axis sigma, imaginary axis is j omega. The right hand side of the S plane I have modified in this manner by taking a small semicircle EFA at the origin, so that now this is the RHS. That means the pole at the origin is given to left hand side of the S plane. That means we have excluded the pole at the origin of the S plane. That's what it means. So now I am going to write the comment. First to find P. This I call figure number 2. The earlier figure automatically means figure 1. Step 1. The pole of G of S, H of S at S is equal to 0 is taken to the left hand side of the S plane. Left hand side of the S plane by drawing a semicircle EFA, semicircle EFA of radius R tending to 0 as depicted in figure 2. The other pole of G of S, H of S is on the left hand side of the S plane. Hence, P is equal to 0. The pole at the origin is taken to left hand side of the S plane. The other pole is automatically on the left hand side of the S plane. Therefore, no poles will lie on the right hand side of the S plane. This means P is equal to 0. The first step in the analysis is over. Second step is we have to do conformal mapping of figure 2. That means the contour ABCDEFA, which is in S plane, has to be mapped onto another plane, which is G of S, H of S plane. The relation between S plane and G of S, H of S plane is given by this mathematical relation. G of S, H of S equals 5 divided by S into S plus 1. Second step to find N. Section 1, to find image of path AB. Equation of path AB is S is equal to J omega. So I will say letting S is equal to J omega in G of S, H of S gives GH of J omega is equal to 5 divided by J omega into J omega plus 1. Now the complex quantities in rectangular form will be converted into polar form. So, 5 divided by j omega means magnitude is omega, angle is 90 degrees. J omega plus 10 means magnitude is root of omega square plus 1 square. Angle is tan inverse of omega divided by 1. Multiply the magnitudes. So, what you get? 5 divided by omega into root of omega square plus 1. Add the angles. When an angle is transferred from denominator to numerator, it takes a negative sign. So, the total angle is, after you add, you transfer it to numerator. The total angle is minus 90 degrees minus tan inverse of omega. This is like M at an angle phi of omega, where M is equal to 5 divided by omega into root of omega square plus 1. And phi of omega is equal to minus 90 degrees minus tan inverse of omega. So this is the expression for M and this is the expression for phi of omega. If you want to get the image of path AB, you have to map point A and point B into G of S, H of S plane. To get the image of point A, we have to take the limit omega tending to plus 0 on the magnitude M and the angle phi of omega. Similarly, to get the image of point B, we have to take the limit omega tending to infinity in the expression for m and in the expression for phi of omega. Limit omega tending to plus 0 gh of j omega is equal to limit omega tending to plus 0 on phi divided by omega into root of omega square plus 1 angle is minus 90 degrees minus tan inverse of omega. For all mathematical purposes, plus 0 is same as 0. Now, if you put the limit omega equal to 0, magnitude will become infinity. Angle will be minus 90 degrees minus tan inverse of 0. Tan inverse of 0 is 0, therefore, you get this as infinity at an angle minus 90 degrees. This is point A dash. A dash is the image of point A. Next, I'll take the limit omega tending to plus infinity on gh of j omega. So this is nothing but limit omega tending to infinity. As omega tends to infinity, what you can do is you can neglect this one with respect to omega square. So you get what? Phi divided by omega into root of omega square. Why we have neglected one? Because omega is a very large quantity, with respect to that very large quantity, this one can be neglected. At an angle, minus 90 degrees, minus tan inverse of omega. If you put omega equal to infinity, magnitude becomes 0. Tan inverse of infinity is what? 90 degrees. So minus 90 minus 90 becomes what? Minus 180 degrees. So 0 at an angle, minus 180 degrees. This is point B dash. B dash is the image of point A dash. So now I am going to draw the image of path AB in G of S, H of S plane. G of S, H of S plane is a complex plane having real axis, real GH, imaginary axis, Z times imaginary GH. This is 0 degrees, minus 90 degrees, minus 180 degrees, minus 270 degrees. Now, this is point A dash. Point A dash. Distance from origin to A dash is infinity. Angle at A dash is minus 90 degrees. I wish to inform the listeners that point A dash is as good as on the minus 90 degree axis. However, I have taken it slightly to the left of minus 90 degree axis. This is point B dash. B dash has got a magnitude equal to 0. Therefore, point B dash is located at the origin of G of S, H of S plane. The angle at B dash minus angle at A dash. Angle at B dash is what? Minus 180 degrees. Angle at A dash is minus 90 degrees. So you get the difference as minus 90 degrees. Minus sign means you will travel clockwise. 90 degree means you will travel in one quadrant. You draw a smooth curve connecting A dash and B dash, and this smooth curve shall lie in the quadrant bounded by the axis minus 90 degrees and minus 180 degrees. The shape of the curve is not important for us, because we are only interested in the encirclement about minus 1 plus j 0 point. So this is the smooth curve connecting point A dash and B dash. So the arrow in this figure is from A to B. Therefore, in its image also, the arrow shall be from A dash to B dash. So the image of path AB is this locus. This locus is also called GH of J omega locus. Some people call this figure as polar plot. Polar plot is nothing but the plot of GH of j omega locus as omega varies from 0 to infinity. For all mathematical purposes, plus 0 is same as 0. So now we have finished image of path AB. Next, I will go to the image of path BCD. Section 2, to find image of path BCD. To find image of path BCD, there are two poles of G of S, H of S, and there are no zeros. Whenever number of poles of G of S, H of S exceed the number of zeros of G of S, H of S, the image of the path BCD, namely B dash, C dash, D dash, will be the origin of G of S, H of S plane. So I'm going to write here, since number of poles of G of S, H of S exceed the number of zeros of G of S, H of S, it implies that the image of the path BCD will be the origin of G of S, H of S plane, will be the origin of G of S, H of S plane. Since number of poles of G of S, H of S exceed the number of zeros of G of S, H of S, it implies that the image of path BCD will be the origin of G of S, H of S plane. Why it is like that? I have shown in the previous two or three problems. In the examination, there will be shortage of time. Therefore, the statement is good enough. Next, path DE and path AB form the images with respect to real axis. Therefore, their images, namely D dash, E dash, A dash, B dash, will also exhibit symmetry with respect to real axis. What I am going to write now is, Section 3, to find image of the path, to find the image of the path D dash E dash is the mirror image. Path D dash E dash is the mirror image of the path A dash B dash with respect to real axis. A very important statement. Last step remaining in this process is to find the image of the path EFA. Section 4, to find image of the path, to find the image of the path EFA. Put S is equal to limit R tending to 0, R into e to the power j phi in GH of S. Phi changes from, at point E, the value of phi is minus 90 degrees. At point F, the value of phi is 0 degrees. At point A, the value of phi is plus 90 degrees. I am going to write here, phi changes from minus 90 degrees through 0 degrees to plus 90 degrees. Minus 90 degrees is at point E, 0 degrees is at point F, plus 90 degrees is at point A. Then, limit R tending to 0, g h of r into e to the power j phi equals limit r tending to 0 phi divided by r into e to the power j phi r into e to the power j phi plus 1. R tends to 0 means r is a very small quantity, therefore neglect r into e to the power j phi with respect to 1. This we have done in the previous problems also. So we get limit r tending to 0 phi divided by r into e to the power j phi into 1. E to the power j phi has got magnitude equal to 1, angle equal to 5. So we will write this as limit r tending to 0 phi divided by r into 1 at an angle 5. If phi goes up it becomes minus 5. So this is limit r tending to 0 phi divided by r at an angle minus 5. Phi divided by 0 is infinity. Now we substitute the values of phi. If you put phi is equal to minus 90 degrees here, you get plus 90 degrees. If you put phi is equal to 0 degrees, you get 0 degrees. If you put phi is equal to plus 90 degrees, you get minus 90 degrees. These are the images E dash, F dash, A dash. Please look at this. EFA was a semicircle of radius r tending to 0. But its image has got a radius equal to infinity. Angle at A dash minus angle at E dash is minus 180 degrees. Minus 180 degrees means minus sign means you will travel clockwise, covering how many quadrants? 2 quadrants. So here the movement is in the anti-clockwise direction. In its image, the movement is in the clockwise direction. Please note this point. Now I will draw the complete Nyquist diagram. The complete Nyquist diagram, the complete Nyquist diagram is as shown below. G of S, H of S plane is a complex plane having real axis real GH, imaginary axis J times imaginary GH. This is G of S, H of S plane. This axis represents 0 degrees. This axis represents minus 90 degrees. This axis represents minus 180 degrees. This axis represents minus 270 degrees. Angles measured in the clockwise direction are negative. If you take anti-clockwise direction, minus 270 is same as plus 90, minus 180 is same as plus 180, minus 90 is same as plus 270. So this image is already drawn earlier. This is point A dash. This is point B dash. B dash, C dash, D dash are at the origin of G of S, H of S plane. Then I draw the mirror image. This is the mirror image. Mirror image is what? D dash, E dash. Symmetry with respect to real axis means if you cut this figure along the real axis, the upper half and the lower half must be identical. Next, we'll draw the image of path EFA. That image shall start at E dash, end at A dash. The angle at A dash minus angle at E dash is what? Minus 90 degrees minus of plus 90, you get minus 180 degrees. The minus sign means you will travel clockwise. 180 degrees means two quadrants, covering two quadrants. So, this is the image. This is the point F dash. The radius of the semicircle is infinity. This is the point minus 1 plus J0. I was telling you, path EFA is traversed in the anti-clockwise direction. Its image is traversed in the clockwise direction. Please note that. One pole at the origin means semicircle EFA is transformed into another semicircle. If there are two poles at the origin, the semicircle EFA will have its image, which is a circle. That I will tell you while doing the remaining problems. So minus 1 plus J0 point is not encircled by the Nyquist diagram. Therefore, N is equal to 0. I am going to write that statement. Since minus 1 plus J0 point is not encircled in the Nyquist diagram, comma, it implies N is equal to 0. The Nyquist stability criterion is Z is equal to P plus N. Hence, Z is equal to P is 0, N is 0, Z equal to 0. Z equal to 0 means no roots of the characteristic equation 1 plus G of S H of S is equal to 0 will lie on the right hand side of the S plane. Hence, closed loop control system is stable. This means no root of the characteristic equation 1 plus G of S H of S is equal to 0 lies on the right hand side of the S plane. Right hand side of the S plane. Hence, closed loop control system, CLCS means closed loop control system or negative feedback system is stable. So we have done the analysis of part 1 of the problem. Next we will go to part 2 of the problem. In part 2, he has told that the pole at the origin should be included. So this is the part. Now we will go to second part. This is the right hand side of the S plane. The pole at the origin is included to the RHS of the S plane. Sigma J omega. This semicircle has got a radius equal to R. This angle is phi. This semicircle has got radius R tending to infinity, angle theta. The entire contour is traversed in the clockwise direction. This is the angle theta. I will label the contour. This is A. This is B. This is C, D, E. This is F, A. A, B, C, D, E, F, A. Equation of path A, B is S is equal to J omega. Equation of this semicircle of radius R is S is equal to limit R tending to 0 R into e to the power j phi. Equation of this semicircle is S is equal to limit R tending to infinity R into e to the power j theta. The images of the paths AB, BCD and DA, DE do not change. So we shall focus only on the image of path EFA. The images of the paths, AB, comma, B, C, D and D do not change. Do not change. So section 4, to find the image of path EFA. Put S is equal to, put S is equal to limit R tending to 0, R into e to the power j phi in GH of S. GH of S is what? Phi divided by S into S plus 1. Phi changes from, variation of phi is different. At point E, phi is minus 90 degrees. At point F, it is minus 180 degrees. And at point A, it is minus 270 degrees. These are the points E. These are the points F. This is the point, this is point A. That is because of the direction of the path E of A. Then, limit R tending to 0, GH of R into e to the power j phi is equal to limit R tending to 0, phi divided by R into e to the power j phi, R into e to the power j phi plus 1 equals limit R tending to 0, e to the power j phi means magnitude is 1, angle is 5. This R into e to the power j phi you can neglect with respect to 1 as we did earlier. Phi divided by 0 is infinity, phi when it goes up it becomes minus 5. Now substitute the values of phi. If you put minus 90 degrees you get plus 90 degrees. If you put minus 180 degrees you get plus 180 degrees. If you put minus 270 degrees you get plus 270 degrees. These are the images E dash, F dash, A dash, E dash, F dash, A dash. Now, what is P? P is, in this case, P is 1. The reason is, the pole at the origin is taken to RHS of the S plane. Therefore, P is 1. That also I am going to write now. Note. The pole of G of S, H of S at S is equal to 0 is taken to the RHS of the S plane by drawing the contour EFA. This I call figure 3 as shown in figure 3. Hence P is equal to 1. In earlier case P was 0. The complete Nyquist diagram is as shown below. G of S, H of S plane is a complex plane having real axis, real GH, imaginary axis J times imaginary GH. This is done earlier. This is the image A dash, B dash. Point B dash, C dash, A dash are at the origin. The mirror image of A dash, B dash is D dash, E dash. This mirror image is symmetrical with respect to real axis. Now you see, angle at A dash minus angle at E dash is equal to 270 degrees minus 90 degrees. which is nothing but 180 degrees. Angle at A dash minus angle at E dash is 270 degrees minus 90 degrees, which is 180 degrees. Plus sign means we have to travel in the anti-clockwise direction. Correct? 180 degrees means covering two quadrants. One quadrant movement means 90 degrees. Movement in the two quadrants means 180 degrees. You will start at E dash, end at A dash, traveling in the anti-clockwise direction, covering two quadrants. This is F dash. The radius is infinity. See, angle at E dash is plus 90 degrees. See, in this direction if you travel, this is plus 90 degrees, this is plus 180 degrees, plus 270 degrees. If you travel from this real axis in the anti-clockwise direction. So, this is minus 1 plus J0 point. See, minus 1 plus J0 point is encircled once. In which direction? Anti-clockwise direction. Again repeat, minus 1 plus J0 point is encircled once in the anti-clockwise direction. Therefore, N is equal to minus 1. I am going to write it now. It is formed from the Nyquist diagram. It is formed from the Nyquist diagram that minus 1 plus J0 point is encircled once in the anti-clockwise direction. In the anti-clockwise direction. Hence, N is equal to minus 1. Anti-clockwise encirclements are taken as negative. Clockwise encirclements are taken as positive. What is Nyquist stability criterion? Z is equal to P plus N. This implies Z is equal to P is 1, N is minus 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. Same result as in part 1. This implies closed loop control system is stable. So what is important is whether you include the pole at the origin or exclude the pole at the origin with respect to right hand side of the S plane. Correct? Right hand side of the S plane. The analysis is not going to change. But normally, the pole at the origin is taken to left hand side of the S plane. That is what I have followed in most of the problems that have been solved. We shall go to next problem. Next problem, a negative feedback system has an open loop transfer function g of s h of s is equal to 1 divided by S plus 1 divided by S plus 1 into S plus 2 into S plus 2 into S plus 3 into S plus 4. We have to investigate the close investigate complicated problem. I will do this problem later. And a simpler one. Figure below shows
the polar plot of an open loop transfer function g of s h of s. Draw the entire Nyquist diagram. Draw the entire Nyquist diagram, and comment upon the closed loop stability. Comment upon the closed loop stability of the system. This is real GH. Y axis is J times imaginary GH. Omega is equal to infinity. The problem is, figure below shows the polar plot of an open loop transfer function g of s h of s. Draw the entire Nyquist diagram and comment upon the stability of the system. Solution. Say omega equal to 0 means it is point A dash. Omega equal to infinity means point B dash. When the angle of GH of J omega locus is 0 degrees, it means no pole of G of S H of S lies at the origin of the S plane. I am going to write, since phi of omega is equal to 0 degrees at omega equal to 0, it implies no poles of G of S H of S are at S is equal to 0. Hence, the right hand side of the S plane, is as shown in figure 2. This I call as figure 1. So again repeat, omega equal to 0 means point A dash, omega equal to infinity means point B dash. In the problem, the image of path A is given to you. Omega equal to 0 is the limit that gives you point A dash. Omega equal to infinity is the limit that gives you point B dash. So figure 2 I am going to write now. There are no poles at S is equal to 0. So don't draw the semicircle EFA at the origin, this is S plane. This is the entire right hand side of the S plane, encompassed by the contour ABCDA. The semicircle has got a radius r tending to infinity. This is the angle theta. At point A, omega is 0. At point B, omega is infinity. At point D, omega is minus infinity. In the problem, this is figure number 2. In the problem, image of path AB is given. To this, we have to add the images, we have to add the images of the paths, images of the paths BCD and DA. The complete Nyquist diagram, the complete Nyquist diagram is as shown in figure 3. See, G of S, H of S plane is a complex plane. G of S, H of S plane is a complex plane. I have real axis, real GH. Imaginary axis, J times imaginary GH. This is G of S, H of S plane. Having real axis, real GH. Imaginary axis, J times imaginary GH. This axis represents 0 degrees. This axis represents minus 90 degrees. This axis represents minus 180 degrees. This axis represents minus 270 degrees when it travels in the clockwise direction. Angles traversed in the clockwise direction are assumed to be negative. So in the problem, this image has been given. This is A dash. This is B dash. This intercept is 2. That means minus 1 plus J0 point is enclosed by the path A dash, B dash. The points B dash, C dash, D dash are assumed to be the origin because we assume number of poles are greater in number than the number of zeros. Note, the number of poles of G of S, H of S are greater than number of zeros of G of S, H of S. Hence, B dash, C dash, D dash goes to the origin of the S plane. That is why B dash, C dash, D dash are at the origin of the S plane. Also, we assume no poles on right hand side of the S plane. Which implies P is equal to 0. Now to this figure, I am going to add the image of the path DA. This is the image of the path DA. Please watch. This is the image of the path DA. The arrow is from D dash to A dash. If you look at this figure is nothing but Nyquist diagram. Minus 1 plus J0 point is encircled twice in the clockwise direction. This is the first encirclement starting here, ending here. This is the next encirclement starting here and again ending at the same point. And both the encirclements are in the clockwise direction. Clockwise encirclements are positive. Therefore, N is equal to plus 2. Because minus 1 plus J0 point is encircled twice in the clockwise direction as seen in the Nyquist diagram. What is Nyquist stability criterion? Nyquist stability criterion is Z is equal to P plus N. This implies Z is equal to P according to our assumption is 0, N is 2. So z is equal to 2. This implies two roots of the characteristic equation 1 plus g of s h of s is equal to 0 lie on the right hand side of the s plane. Right hand side of the s plane. Hence, closed flow control system is unstable. So, in this problem, he has not given the transfer function g of s h of s. He has given the image of path AB. Using that image, we have found the stability. How we have done it? To the image A dash B dash, we have added the images B dash C dash D dash and D dash A dash. That has resulted in a diagram called Nyquist diagram. If you look at this diagram, minus 1 plus J0 point is encircled twice in the clockwise direction. This is first encirclement. This is the next encirclement. Since minus 1 plus J0 point is encircled twice, n is equal to plus 2. The Nyquist stability criterion is z is equal to p plus n. We have assumed that no poles of g of s, h of s are the right hand side of this plane. That is the assumption made. Because of that assumption, p is 0. So we have got z equal to 2. What is the implication of z equal to 2? The implication is two roots of the characteristic equation 1 plus g of s, h of s is equal to 0 lie on the right hand side of this plane. Hence, closed loop control system is unstable. Similar one more problem, I do it in the next class. Before you come to the next class, please go through whatever I have done in detail and then come. Thank you.